The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Money Masters. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Tom O'Brien and Tommy O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here. Right now, we have the Dow on 61, Nasdaq's down 19, S&Ps are off 8.5. We have gold down 820 at 1283. You get silver down 10 cents at $17.37. Light sweet crude's up $1.14. We're going to have oil numbers at 10:30 this morning. That's, right. That's a beautiful thing. That's always a beautiful thing.
For sure.
Bonds, the 10-year note is down 2 ticks, the 30-year bonds off 3 ticks, and good old King dollars up 374. Volatility. Once again, the currency markets in a huge way. You know, we had King dollar get down to 91.88 yesterday. This is the index. Rejected the low. You know, we'll see where this bounce wants to bring us, man. And as we do each and every day, we go over to our man, Mr. Kevin Hinks from TD Ameritrade Thinkorswim. And don't forget, folks, every trading day, 12 to 1 Eastern Standard Time, Kevin, Scott, Cindy, they have a great show, 12 to 1 Swim lessons. You can get it right on your cell phone, TFNN.com, hit Tiger TV. Kevin Hinks, what's going on?
Good morning, Tom. Good morning, Tommy. Inventory day.
That's right.
That one, right?
Well, hey, let me tell you, man, you know, yesterday, folks, if you caught the program yesterday, Kevin and I and Tommy, we were talking about what the program was going to be about. It was about skew. And it was so cool, Kevin, because when you guys were actually talking, what I realized is that you had been talking about explaining what skew is, and in that case, they were using the aspect of a put. But what was happening in the gold market, Kevin, is that the skew was on the calls, and they were whacked out, man.
And so that happens a lot in commodities, Tom.
Yeah, it was really cool to understand.
Really is, right, because when you make the transition from trading stock options to commodity options, a lot of times, almost always, the skew goes to the upside because that's where you see the larger moves, and that's where the option order flow perceives the risk to be.
Yeah, no, and that's what I got out of the conversation that you and Scott were having, which was really cool, man, because and what happens, folks, is this, is that when you understand it and then you have positions, you can anticipate. Well, I like always doing it the bull and the bear in my head prior to it so that you're ready when it happens. Do you know what I'm saying? Because when you first look at it, the skew, like I was looking at it last week, I'm saying to myself, something's wrong here, man. You know what I mean? I felt at that point, let's put it this way, they were giving me too much. And I says, okay, so instead of hitting the, I says, hold it, I really got to figure this out, man. Am I missing something? You know?
Right.
And I was missing
every
what.
Now and then.
Yeah, I was. Now I know what skew means, so it's a beautiful thing.
A very small percentage of the time that you trade skew in regular options. You saw it last year one time in Facebook where skew flattened out.
Okay.
Actually went a little bit to the call. And you see it sometimes when stocks will split. Right before a stock split, it's perceived as bullish, and sometimes the skew will flip. But usually, mostly time, if you see a flattening or a positive skew to the calls in stocks, it's really bullish in terms of direction.
That's cool to know, man. Okay.
And it's a message,
Yeah.
Great.
So today, inventories, right?
Inventories in oil. We're going to talk about oil. We're going to talk about everything going on in oil. And, Tom, I invite you guys to look at a chart of oil from last year at this time and look at what happened between now and about the mid to end of June. There was kind of a seasonal rally in oil that ended at the end of June into a sharp sell-off. Because remember, seasonally, you're changing blends now, right?
Okay.
So you saw distillates draw down, gasoline draw down, but inventories keep going up, right? Because you're moving out of the winter blend into the summer blend.
But we were talking about oil went from 65 to 50, folks, and we're at a heartbeat. You know, well, 44. 2 months, right?
Yeah,
44. Right. Yeah, cool, so man.
It's real interesting time of the year in oil to see how that's going to wash out as you're changing into new thing, but inventories in oil still piling up.
Yeah. And there's no doubt that we get the volatility all over the marketplace, man. I mean, it's just pretty amazing. No doubt.
It's interesting. The dollar was extremely. How about the range yesterday on the dollar?
Seriously. That was. Oh. Yep.
That's a big one.
And it is a big one. And we know that, the dollar, folks, has been in a downtrend for quite a while. The real, key here is going to be, is this a reversal or is it just a counter-trend bounce, So we'll know that once it gets up to 93.80 or something, Right now, it's just, it doesn't look to me that much at this particular point anyway.
Right. Yeah, a lot of things we're looking at, though. We're looking at China. Of course, is always in play. We're looking at the dollar. We're looking at oil. A lot of things today. But today we're talking about on the show double calendars and double diagonals.
Double calendar. I like it. Okay, man.
Yeah. Volatility trades.
We're going to get smart. It's a beautiful thing. Listen, folks, right here, 12 to 1 Eastern Standard Time. Remember, if you're on the West Coast right now, listening to Car Radio, just go to TFNN.com, hit Tiger TV. Great show, and of course, every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, we have live programming, 8 in the morning to 5 in the afternoon, Tuesday, Thursday, 7 to 6 in the afternoon. Kevin, you have a great one, safe one, and of course, we look forward to listening to the show.
Always a pleasure, guys. Have a good one.
Thanks, Kevin. Take care. Have a great one. Have a safe one. Volatility out here, we got it in spades. Dow right now is only down 27. It was down about 870-80. You get the NASDAQ off 15. S&P's down 6. Tommy and I are coming right back, folks. You stay right there.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you'll lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated fulvic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
We take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is down 38. You get the NASDAQ off 15. S&Ps are down 7. We have gold down 780. You got silver off 10 cents. King Dollar's up 359. And we get a big night tonight. My man, Mr. Andy Hecht, right?
He is. He's starting off his commodity trading course tonight. Yep. We've been discussing it. He's got 12 total lessons, three lessons per night. Each lesson will be about 45 minutes, 40 minutes. So each night's going to be about 2 hours. So he'll go from 5:30 till 7:30 tonight. And he's got three lessons. All the lessons are laid out right on the front page. We've discussed it before. And why not sign up for it? That way you can attend the first night. And if you can't attend it, like we've discussed, we're going to archive all the 12 lessons, all individually. You'll have them for at least a year. If you need them longer than that, just let us know. We'll extend it. But that way you can watch it as many times as you want.
And folks, just come right over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see it right on the front page. It's going to be an amazing course. And, you know, bottom line is that commodities, you know, when you look back 20, 30 years, commodities used to only trade in the futures market.
Sure.
Now does they have an ETF for everything.
Yes,
you know.
No. I mean, and so many of the equities, well, we talk about the oil companies, right? We talk about, you know, you got natural gas, oil, gold this morning. You were just pulling it up over the break.
Totally.
About like $10 over the,
right.
like the last
right.
5 minutes.
Well, and, you know, if we stay with that for a second, what you're going to see is this. Now, if you haven't test drove the Nadex platform, you got to get over here, okay? Hit the banner. You can test drive it and put $25,000 of paper money into your account. And first we'll show you, you know, what I think's going on with gold anyway. So, well, we had intraday out here. And this is early in the morning, but this is pretty cool how this is shaking out. So, what you had is this. At the first downdraft was at 5:40 this morning, Eastern Standard Time. Now, when I say the first downdraft, I'm talking about with volume, okay?
Okay.
So we came down, and you came down with 4,400 contracts, right? So when you're coming into a swing point, what I'm always looking for is I'm looking for a rejection of price with lower volume. Even and if you're driving in your car right now, I have this on a 10-minute chart, folks. So when I saw that, I'm normally up pretty early anyway, so I saw that. I said, oh, this is going to get interesting. And the reason I thought it was going to get interesting is that it was coming into the highs of the 28th
okay.
of April. And on the 28th of April, we had 5,500 contracts at 1278.
Okay.
That's what we traded, right? So I didn't bite on the first one. But then what happened is that it turned around. So that was at 1278. And then at 6:30, it went to 1277. And we only did 1,700 contracts. I says, okay, here we go. So 1,700 contracts versus at the 540 level, which was the 4,400, versus what it was going into, which was the 1278. So if we go back over to Nadex, what you're going to see is that in this case here, and I'll go with one contract.
Perfect.
So what I did here, if we bring this chart up, let's see, right here, right? Okay. So at, I believe I did this at 6:30 this morning.
Why don't you just expand the Nadex chart?
Okay, yeah. So at 6:30 on that test, folks, what I did is that I went in, there was a spread that was from 1275 to 1375. And, you know, that's in one way, that's a dangerous spread because what happened is it was a 1277. Do you know what I'm saying?
Okay, so we're right down here.
Yeah.
Right? What time were you getting in it at?
I got in at 6:30.
Yeah, 6:43.
So
perfect. Yeah. So somewhere, I mean, that's literally right here. This bar.
I waited for the second test.
That's a good. Yeah.
Right I waited
here.
For the second
small
test.
Small little red bar. Yep.
And this is what's so cool. If you wait and then you just put the risk versus the reward together with the Nadex product, especially in something like gold. Okay. The risk versus the reward was very minimal, you know.
Now, so just to put it in, you know, you got in at 1281.30, so call it, you know, just 1281 for all intensive, and so you're in here. So, you know, you can see the premium level where, you know,
you're paid premium.
Yeah, no, but it is, I'd agree. I mean, if you just, I mean, this is, where you're getting in it, right?
Right.
And
well, I got in lower, but I was paying the $12.81.
That's right. I'm just demonstrating. Right. That's your break even. That's a better way to put it.
Exactly.
That's your break even.
Exactly. Yeah. Right. Right. And so, you know, what ended up happening is so I was risking. What did I risk? I risked.
It would be $63 probably.
Yeah. For.
And the whole thing represents 500. So you take the 500 minus the 63. Right. 437.
Right, for 63.
Right.
Yeah. And I certainly am not looking for the 1325, but I was looking for about 1300, and we've hit 1290 thus far.
Yeah. You know, so I mean, you got a volatile move, that's for sure, which is you're paying premium for a volatile market, hopefully to the upside, you know,
right.
to your direction.
Right.
And you have till 130. This is a daily contract that you're in.
So and if I wasn't just driving to work, I probably should have took something at 1290.
Yeah, it's tough. I mean, not that it's tough, but you know, in fairness, you're still not even at the middle of that spread, so it's going to be trading pretty close to. It depends what you think the market's going to do, right?
Right.
No matter.
Right. Well, I guess what the difference is at that 1290, that's another 6.5. Well, we've been up 450, so it's not the end of the world.
That wasn't per contract.
No, that was for what I have on. Sorry.
Yeah, I know.
Sorry. Okay. So let's go back to the market, because the market out here today, man, is going to be, it looks to me like we got some action here. So market's trying to come back, can't handle coming back. If we go to the NQs first, let's go look at the NQs. So the NQs, well, it's not bad. The NQs look like... So the high of today is so far is 43.21. 43.21, that was the bar from 10 minutes ago. It looks like that's going to get tested again, you know?
Yeah.
But all it's doing is come up to ice thus far. You know, thus far it's going to need a lot more to get above 43.22, you know?
And let's just, as we do it, we got 2 minutes till the break. We got 5 minutes till oil. And let's just take up
good.
Some of the oil for sure.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about oil. How could I forget about oil, man? Oil will rock this market. So 44.54 right now, huh? Okay.
And, you know, it's interesting. What I like to pull up sometimes just to check it out prior to big events like this. And this is where,
right.
you know, if people want to download the demo account, you get a feel for what's priced into it. I'm going to size it down even. And so this is the binaries.
Okay.
Just taking a look.
Yes.
And that expired 11.
Okay.
So you're basically trading all. Yeah.
Yeah.
And in the same way, I'll pull up. Let's just see commodity spreads, crude oil. That's the same thing. They're going to have 150 points, as in $1.50 spreads, that expired 11. And so oil is at about 44.50. You know, depending if you were bullish. That's a good trade right there.
Yeah, look at that. $37 for $113.
Yeah.
And how big was that spread?
Not
only
much.
75. 45.75.
What? Only 75? Yeah.
40, which 50. Is not bad.
Wait, $1.50.
Yeah, I mean, 45.75 was the top pot.
Yes.
And we're at 44. Yes. Yeah, that can do that in a heartbeat, man.
So we'll see what happens. But it's interesting. You got about, you know, looking at the binaries again, 60 cents to the upside, you're talking about 5-1s. 60 cents to the downside, like 5-1s. So we'll see if those...
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Stay right there, folks. Tommy and I are coming right back.
If you're looking to discover a new financial resource and diversify your financial portfolio, don't miss out on the Market Safe Commodity Solutions CD from EverBank. This is the second running of their popular 5-year U.S. dollar-denominated CD, which gives you exposure to 8 equally weighted commodities, including WTI crude oil, gold, silver, copper, nickel, soybeans, corn, and sugar. With annual pricing caps of 70% per component, you could earn up to 70% upside payment at maturity if the commodities increase in value across annual pricing dates. And should the opposite occur, your principal is 100% protected. Keep in mind, returns are based on CD performance. There's no annual percentage yield or periodic rate of interest on this indexed CD. Don't miss out. Take advantage of this financial resource designed to grow with the times. The May 19th funding deadline is quickly approaching. So hurry over to everbank.com/TFNN for the CD's term sheet and other important product details and disclosures. Once again, that's everbank.com/TFNN. This advertisement is sponsored content. EverBank is a member FDIC.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit TFNN.com.
TFNN is excited to offer a brand new piece of market scanning software unlike anything the industry has ever seen. John Logan and his team have spent years developing their market profile tools to finally be able to release the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. And right now, you can get a 2-week trial absolutely free just by visiting TFNN.com and providing us your name and email address. The TAS Profile Scanner Plus is the premier market profile-based scanner in the industry, powered by the acclaimed TAS proprietary algorithms. This feature-rich scanner is a standalone desktop software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Within 3 minutes of signing up, you can have the software downloaded and running on your computer with a complete roadmap of market indicators and inflection points to trade off using the TAS Profile Scanner Plus. Sign up today and try this amazing piece of software by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. So let's see what the inventories are. Oil.
Yeah, did you have it up? I thought you... Where... You had the screen up.
Yeah, let's see.
There it is.
So they rose 2.78 million barrels.
Yeah, I happen to see that the Bloomberg user survey expected a rise of like 1.2. Now, that's not the median estimate, though. That's a different number.
Okay.
So I don't know what
right.
that, but either way, it probably means that there's more oil out there, and that's why the price is tanking,
yeah.
at least on the initial.
Right.
We'll see where that changes.
And so we just went from 44.56 to 44.16,
yeah.
right?
And really, you know, this bar, we went from 44.58 all the way down to 44.09. So, you know, you get those big moves right away.
Right.
Like we see it. We'll see if it holds for sure.
And, you know, we've had, you know, I mean, it's been a huge acceleration up anyway. So it would totally make sense that you get a pullback, right? I mean, it's not the end of the world.
Right.
CLM6. Yeah, well, that's a delayed quote, which is not going to give us any help. Back to that. Well, that's putting some pressure on the marketplace. Yeah. So if we go into, let's go into some.
Let me just double click to get this.
Thank you. We go into Exxon. We go into Exxon Mobil. No, that's flat. The XLE. Yeah, she's got some pressure on the way down. Yeah, she's actually breaking the... So the XLE is breaking a small ABC down, intraday. We'll see where that shakes out. Market-wise, what you have out here, yeah, the USO will pull that up. Market-wise, you get the Dow down 50, NASDAQ's down 22, S&Ps are off 850. And let's go over to that dollar index, because the dollar... Okay, so the dollar's been on a one-way trip. There's no doubt about that on the way down. Now... What it looks like we have out here thus far is that it hasn't been able to get over this 93.48 area. What's interesting is that when I was listening to John Logan this morning, right, if you bring up the TAS profiles, right, now this is where this gets cool, folks. If you haven't test drove the TAS profiles, right, so the profiles, you have the 60-minute, then you have the 240, then you have the daily and the weekly. So what happens is that, you know, on the weekly, it's still negative in the dollar, meaning going down. On the daily,
is it below profile?
It's below profile, yes. Okay, so you're still selling
it. The downward, yes.
Right. What happened on the 240, however, is that it's like saying you better be really careful.
Okay.
Well, on the 60, which was really cool, is that 93.14 is the top of the profile.
Okay.
Isn't that wild?
Yeah.
You know, so I was looking at it, it says, oh, this is an important number.
Yes.
And, you know, it busted it 10 minutes ago. Now it's below it again, and it's hovering around that area. So,
cool.
I know, isn't that weird? It's pretty cool, man. I'm just watching that thing shake out. We go over to the USO, which is the oil fund. And this is a real quote, though. Let's see what just happened here. Yeah, this is not going down that much. Okay, so that was 10:30. We're at $11, now you're 10.92. We go back, and let's look at back. Look at that.
Yeah, that's why, because we got to pop.
Exactly, exactly. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Let's go over and take a look at a stock that's really getting smoked out here. Is Wrangell Resources this morning. So, Wrangell, folks, this is one of the...
I was just going to say, rough earnings will do that, right?
Oh, baby. We got to look at this. So, Wrangell, I mean, we don't own this, but this is one of the premier gold stocks, there's no doubt. It's down $9.32.
Which is over 10%.
Yeah.
Or right around 10%, I think.
You know, it's been in a consolidation for quite a while. It's coming back into where it did have some strength from... Now, numbers go like this on Wrangell. Let's take a look at this. Okay, so we'll see if we can get Mark on and give him an email later.
They got production down.
Yes.
Go ahead. But it seems to be their production decreased. They couldn't get it out of the ground, right? Or they just weren't trying to...
They couldn't get it out of the ground. That's
no matter what, for the prices. I mean, you always talk about maybe they just weren't willing to go after some of that gold that was harder to get, right, at these prices, or as it was rising. There's a million things that go into it, but they didn't produce as much as the market wanted them to. That's
right.
The bottom line.
Well, we'll have to get good old Mark on and see what he has to say. So the gold sales are $345 million. Their first quarter production was down 11% quarter over quarter, Q over Q.
Yeah. Interesting part is that they have profits rising. So it's all just expectations, right?
First quarter rose 25% year over year and rose 19% quarter over quarter.
I guess no matter what, you should be making more money than you were a year ago if you're a gold company and everything's going as it should be.
As in,
who's making less money right now just because you're selling your metal for so much more?
Yes, no doubt.
But guess what? The market probably said you probably should have made more than 25% more with how much gold is going up, and they just didn't pull enough of it maybe out of the ground.
Oh, listen, there's no doubt. And this afternoon, we're going to know a lot more, too, because this afternoon, after the close, we have, today's the 4th, right?
Yes.
Yeah, we have Yamana coming out with numbers after the close. We have Great Panther coming out after the close, yep. Right now, Great Panther is trading, it's down 14 cents. At 161, Yamana is down 11 cents at 443. And
just going to check back in on oil while we're checking up. Yeah,
we'll see.
I mean, we're at about 55. So we're 30 cents lower.
Right. So on the binary. So let's go through the binary.
So these are 11 a.m. binaries. So you got to keep everything. You know, that's where they have binaries, and you can see right on the left-hand side here, we have 11 a.m., 12 o'clock, 2:30s are the daily, and these are the separate dailies, just like in the indices where they reset kind of previous night, and then they're resetting at 8 in the morning again. So 11 o'clock in the morning, we have, what are we at? We got 24 minutes, 23 minutes. And this is where, you know, if you're paying less premium because guess what? You're only paying it for 20 minutes.
Which is dynamite.
Right? Well, it's dynamite if you're right. You know, it's dynamite. I'm just, you know, it's dynamite for the way you like to trade, right?
The way I like to trade, for sure. Right. No, but you know what I'm saying? There's no sense paying for it if you think it's going to go there right then, right?
Right. Yes, yes. For if you're just trading it to be in over this news, for sure.
Right.
For sure. Yeah. So we'll see what happens. But, you know, the interesting thing to realize, so we said 60 cents up, 60 cents down was about 5-1. This is, I think, the one that jumped out because we're at about 50, 44.55, 43.96. And you can see the market's dropped about even 20 cents. And this is at the same level, right?
Yeah.
And that's because guess what? There's a lot priced in there.
Right.
Yeah, and this is where, you know, I think the demo, you download it and you see how these move. Because sometimes I look at some of the weekly indice binaries.
Right.
And, like, for instance, I had taken a peek at the NASDAQ, I think, maybe Monday, or it was ahead of the big drop yesterday. And you were correct, but they didn't move as much as you think they would move. If you had bought one of those 5-1 out of the money.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
And that's because there was a lot of premium priced in for 5 days when you know how much the market's been moving.
Right. You stay right there, folks. Tommy and I are coming right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. You have the market, the Dow rather down 45, NASDAQ off 21, S&P's down 850. We're going to be right back.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. We hit the Dow down 56, NASDAQ's down 24, S&Ps are down 10. We have gold down 690. Now, let's go over to the gold market for a second, because I want to show you something here. So, inside gold, folks, what we have intraday, and this is going to be cool to look at to see, you know, what the correlation is. So, the first correlation on the way up was great, right? You know, we had a buyer that came in the marketplace, and it goes topside at 8 o'clock in the morning. You have the white price spread, you have the accelerated volume, you have all of the above, right? Well, we get to a price point at 8:20 a.m. at 1291.50, and you have 10,000 contracts, right? Now watch this, folks, because this is crucial to understand just how when you can't get price, because this is just the opposite of what has been happening. Then we get back up there again, and you only do 4,300 contracts on the 10-minute. Well, 4,300 at the 10,000, it's like, okay, couldn't handle it. Now, this is where the danger point comes in for me. Then what ends up happening is that you have a seller with 10,000 contracts.
Yeah.
It's like, uh-oh, okay?
And the seller 10,000 is bigger than the buyer 10,000.
That's right.
If you get to the...
Right, and watch. I'm going to show you something else. Now, this is crucial to understand because I'm bullish this, but it's like, okay, you know, it's like, okay, man, hold it. We got a seller. But guess what? The identification of that seller is more brutal, and this is why. Because if I go over, now, what I've been doing is that, you know, when I've been buying, I've been showing you the bottom of why. Well, on the top, that same, I don't know if it's the same seller, but at 10:30 yesterday, you can see when gold went from 1293 to 1287, 9200.
Sure, 10:20
and
yesterday.
The way that I look at things, it's like, okay, man, this seller come back in the market again. Whack, whack, whack. So now, what do I need? I need a buyer. you know, and we'll see. So what happens there is this, is that, okay, where it went topside from, which is a 1281, is the key, okay? And, you know, we'll see what kind of cause it gets built and if it can make it higher. So that's the yin and the yang on both sides of how that's working. And so right now, you know, basically the market is saying the bulls and bears are fighting like crazy.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Right at that level.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know. We'll do the correlation inside the dollar index, because the dollar index will be the fight. And inside the dollar index, you're going to see we got topside at 10 o'clock, and we do 1,600 contracts. And then, oh, this is good for me. And then we go down with 1,800. That's testing that area. So that correlation there is saying, okay, you still got someone else that's a seller. Well, we can see that we get quite a day happening out here. The market again, looks like we get some sellers out here, man. The bond market. This bond market's so tricky, man. It's unbelievable.
Yeah, it's volatile too, right?
It is, man.
For sure.
It is. So yesterday, what it's trying to do is get into this April 20th area, $130.19. And that was our downdraft. That's a second downdraft from the highs. This just might be it today. It might. When I say just might be it, it might be where you could pull the switch on it. So we had 1.29 million contracts on the 20th. We had 1.22 yesterday. And what you'd want to see is that you want to see lighter volume today than yesterday and on that downdraft. And of course, our rates, if we look at it, we're still at 1.8. That's such a great rate, man. I don't know what the market's going to do, man, if rates ever do go up. I mean, just like you said, you've never seen high rates.
Right.
You know, I mean, the more that this happens, it's more like, man, you know, they're going to have to be really careful.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
Change the whole landscape of everything.
Right.
Yeah.
And what is pretty cool here, folks, is that I can't picture them going up that quick because of the fact that the biggest debtor, one of the biggest debtors, are all the central governments. So it's like, okay, when the rates are going down, you know, people are mad because savers, no doubt, you know, are getting hurt. But what happens is that governments are so in debt, well, they're paying less money on their debt.
Sure.
So it's like, okay, you know. Some of the, okay, so let's go inside the indices out here, because it looks like this thing's starting to get some juice on the way down. Inside the Dow, we have McDonald's is the mover on the way up. That's up a 1%, 161. Disney's up 0.3%. IBM's up 0.2%, and Procter & Gamble's up 0.2%. On the way down, you get United Technologies down 1.7%. Cisco's down 1.5, Goldman's down 1.5, and Caterpillar's down 1.3. Inside the NDX, so I want to see what Priceline's doing, man. I don't think Priceline's the number. So check this out. Priceline's down 10%. $136. They come out with numbers this morning. They, look what it's doing. It's going to fill that gap. Yeah, let's pull this back a little. Wow. So this is Priceline, man. It goes from 1476, November of 2015, to 954. then tries to get in. So if you want to see how you can come back and, you know, huge counter-trend bounce. Isn't that crazy?
Depends what you deem as crazy. But it's not, the markets moving up and down is the definition of the markets.
Yeah,
no?
I know it is.
What's
it is.
Crazier
it,
than it's
well, when something can go
we've
from
we've been dealing with some volatile
from
markets
954
recently.
Back up to 1361 sure. And then fall apart.
You know? Yeah, well, fall apart. Yeah, I mean it was almost where it was at 4 days ago, to put it in the same. Just to keep everything, you know.
I mean, okay, it Priceline.
Yes, I mean pull up the chart. Where was it? The low like 4 days ago. Oh no! Okay, you had a much different. I thought you had.
Yeah, you're right.
I thought
right.
You were looking at dailies. You were jumping around so quick, I couldn't even keep track of what chart we were looking at then.
The inside that NDX. So Priceline's number one the way down. INCY is down 3.9%. TripAdvisor is getting hit because of Priceline, evidently 3.8%, and Mylan Pharmaceutical is down 3.6%. We go take a look at the biotechs, IBB. Yeah, they're heading south too. They're down 578. So there's some pressure on this market, man. The volumes out here, you get 256 on the NYSE. On the NASDAQ, we're dealing, look at that NASDAQ. The NASDAQ keeps accelerating. 520. So let's go back over and look at that oil market.
So it's interesting. It's jumping around right at that level that we happen to choose out. We'll see where it closes out around 11. But this was the 43.96 that was originally, I think, trading at about 80 by 87. So you could have sold it.
That's pretty good.
At the 80 for about a, you know. Risking one to
four.
Make four, right. Exactly. You got to be correct about 20% of the time to be break even.
You stay right there, folks. Tommy and I are coming right back.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD. Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-Share Bull and Bear ETFs. China A-Shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
It's 2016 and TFNN has a brand new programming lineup to kick things off. Starting January 4th, Swim Lessons by Thinkorswim and TD Ameritrade will be airing 5 days a week at noon Eastern Time. Join hosts Scott Connor, Kevin Hinks, and Cindy Faber as they host their daily options program live at noon 5 days a week with no commercials for the entire hour. Nico DeHaan and Paige Clark will be moving their program, Living a Primal Lifestyle, to twice a week, Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 a.m. until 8 a.m. Eastern Time. Wake up with Nico and Paige and start your day off right. The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour by Nadex will now be live Mondays and Fridays at 10 a.m. Start and end the week with the three hosts, Tom O'Brien, Tommy O'Brien, and Daryl Martin, as they break down the world of trading binary options and spreads. For all the details on the new 2016 programming lineup, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN. Educating investors.
Catch Basil Chapman as he uses his Chapman Wave methodology to call the markets. The Tiger Technician's Hour, next on TFNN.
Welcome back, folks. We get the Dow down 76, NASDAQ's off 31, S&Ps are down 12. And let's see what this is, the home of the Kentucky Derby. So let's see, with the Kentucky Derby just days away, Churchill Downs is in a bit of a rut. Not the storied Louisville racetrack, Churchill Downs, the stock. Shares versus the venue with a, this Sunday, right? First one is Sunday?
Saturday, I think.
Saturday, okay, cool, okay. First Saturday of May, right? Will be held Saturday, plunged 12% in 5 days. Ooh, let's see, what is this, what's the symbol of this stock? Let's see. Normally, the symbol's right there.
Is it in the chart somewhere?
Should be. No, sorry, folks. Sorry about that. I should have had that. I always like watching that, though.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, no doubt.
Especially after we got such a treat last year with the Triple Crown.
I know. Yeah. Huge, right? Yeah. And, well, you know, now, I guess there's not a horse that has that much publicity this year because I haven't heard anything.
Yeah, but what is that compared to what? Are you normally in tune with the pre-Kentucky Derby hype? I don't think anybody is. That's my point. You didn't know.
It just starts there,
you
right?
You didn't know who the horse was last year either before he
No, I think so because that guy. He's a big promoter.
There's three or four big promoters that have three or four horses in every race.
Oh yeah, no, I'm talking about the owner, not the Egyptian guy. He was basically pretty good promoter, a big promoter. Market wise out here, folks, what you're looking at is this. So if we take a look at the actual swing points and the SPY, this is what you're dealing with. We're right at the lower swing inside the SPY. The swing point in the SPY is $205.03. 142 million shares, and you know, the SPY could do 142 million. We're at 32 million right now in an hour. We'll see whether it slows down or not. The NDX 100, the Qs, I don't think have made it to the lowest swing. The lowest swing inside the Qs is $104.88. We made it to 104.97. The IWM actually got a pop this morning. And it gave it up. So the IWM is, see, that it's interesting. This broke the swing yesterday with volume. and intraday. It looked, I thought this had got to pop intraday. Yeah, it did. Okay, so intraday, right at the get-go, folks, it got to pop. It was up to $111.99, but just gave it up. You know, so we'll see how this the rest of the day shakes out. But it looks to me like you're going to continue to have selling pressure on the way down, and the real kick is going to be like, do you have that expansion of volume so you get ABC structures on the way down? Gold is going to be, let me just go over there quickly and see where that seller is. So if you're bullish on gold, what you want to see is this bar where the 10,000 was tested, of course, with lighter volume. That would be a test of 1283. Well, if you're bearish, you want to see, of course, that seller come right back in and boom, blow it away.
Right?
Yep, no doubt about it. But right now, let's see, we're at, you're 8 minutes into the bar, and this, you know, it would have been nice if this just got a little lower. It was 1283.20. It's not bad, though. You know, they haven't been able to do it yet, but that doesn't mean that it kind of come out of nowhere. You know, it looks to me, though, and what to always remember inside the gold market is this. What they like to do is really run it when the pit's closing at 1:30, okay, up or down. You stay right there, folks. The man, Mr. Basil Chapman's coming up next. And, of course, then TD Ameritrade Thinkorswim, Steve Rhodes, Dave White, myself. And, of course, don't forget Andy's workshop tonight, folks. Check it out on the front page of TFNN.
Thanks, pal.
Go get them, folks.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.